Hello, my name is Molly Lyles, a horticulture agent with the LSU Ag Center in the Central Region. And in this video, I will be talking about three ways that you can utilize Excel to help plan your garden. In this video, I will be showing you how I use Excel for garden planning, specifically for calculating succession plantings, determining planting dates based on a desired harvest time, and figuring out harvest dates based on your planting date and days until harvest. The first way that I will show you how to use Excel is using Excel to calculate succession plantings. Succession planting is a technique that allows you to harvest crops continually throughout the growing season. Instead of planting everything at once, you stagger your plantings at regular intervals. This ensures a longer, more consistent harvest period. Many seed packets include recommendations for how often to plant for a continual harvest. You will often see on a seed packet, it say, for continual harvest, plant every 2 weeks. This is essentially succession planting. You can take that information that they suggest, or you can determine how often you want to plant this crop, and you can input it into the Excel file using a simple formula to get your planting dates for these successions. And then you can also determine the harvest dates based on the planting dates that you get and the days until harvest that variety has. And so with this one, it's a simple formula. You're just adding the planting date to the days until harvest. But the first cell, the first planting date that you have will be the only one that you have to input. So I will say in this example that the first day that I will seed Pac-Man broccoli will be September 1st. And then after that, I will simply just calculate using a formula to add 14 days to the date that I started with. So it's a simple formula. You on your keyboard, you click the enter equal sign, and then you add E17, which is this cell, the September 1st cell, E17 plus D17, which is your days between plantings or your planting intervals. Then you click the enter sign and it will calculate that date for you based on the formula. Once you have that initial formula input, you can simply just drag it down and it will populate the rest of the cells using that same formula, but with the corresponding cells to calculate for. The next thing that you can determine after you have your planting date is your expected harvest date. This is determined by the planting date and the days until harvest. So it's the same calculation. It's equal sign E17 plus C17. So you're adding the planting date to the days until harvest to get that harvest date. And then after that, you have that formula input in there, so you can simply drag it down to populate the rest of the cells that you want to calculate. So this is one way that I've used Excel for garden planning. The next way that I'll talk about is to calculate for planting date. So this way came about because I had a farmer who had a specific crop that they were harvesting around a certain time. They knew they were having that crop around that time, and they wanted other crops to accompany that crop to market to have more variety. And so I took the desired harvest date that they wanted, and I looked at different crops and different varieties that grew well in their area that they were at. And I determined the planting date that they'd have to start those plants to have that harvest date around the same time as their other crops that they were bringing to market. Another example is I think of whenever you have a special event, if you had a special event and you wanted an influx of crops to harvest for to have produce ready, you can use this to determine that planting date for that harvest date. Or in this example, I used pumpkins because it's a really popular thing during October, during the fall. And so you might want to have a pumpkin patch. And so you want a specific harvest date or a maturity time. And so this would be one of those examples. So with this one, it's a simple formula. It's essentially the same formula that I went over on the succession planting, but instead of adding these two numbers together, or the date and this number together, you're subtracting because you're finding the planting date. And so it's a simple equal sign, and then you want to subtract E22, you know, just subtract October 1st to the days until harvest, which is 130 for this specific row. And so minus C22. And then you click enter and it will calculate that date for you. And then you can just drag that down and it will populate the rest with the same formula and give you the answer. So this is the other way that I like to use Excel for calculating. I think this would be really useful if you had a certain, or this one is really useful if you have a certain harvest date that you have in mind and you want to get those plants ready for that. See how they're pretty much, there's a few that have the same days until harvest, but for the most part, they all have different days until harvest, which means that you want to plant them at different times for a specific harvest date. The third method I use is to calculate the harvest date based on the planting date and the days until harvest. This is especially helpful when you already know when you're planting and need to figure out when to expect to harvest. I like, for this example, this is essentially succession planting, but you're planting at one time, which can be really beneficial, especially in our Louisiana weather where it rains a lot. If you are direct seeding, sometimes with succession plantings, you have to delay your planting day because it rains and you can't go out in the field. And so this is one way that you can reduce the chance of losing a harvest date is by planting different varieties with different days until harvest at the same time. So this is the same formula that we used for the succession planting to determine the harvest date. And so it's a simple equal sign, and then you are adding D15, the planting date, to the days until harvest. So it's D15 plus C15. Then you click enter, and it will calculate that number, that date for you. You drag it down, and it populates the rest of the cells for you. So these are the three main ways I've used Excel for garden planning, whether you're calculating succession plantings, figuring out when to plant for a specific harvest date, or calculating your harvest date based on your planting schedule. Excel can make it an easier process and streamline it a little bit more. I hope this is helpful. That's all for today. Thank you for listening and happy gardening.